I once thought Pete Davidson was just like Obama, biracial goofball who ruined a once beloved institution, but it turns out I was wrong. Pete's not biracial.
Good one.
And now for the man of the hour.
I know you're a funny dude as well. Because the other night I told one of your super funny jokes to a supermodel, and she was laughing while I was banging her brains out with the pile of money on the floor of my motherfucking mansion. Now let's get to the real situation, my man Donald Trump. People are hating on him because Trump is always firing people, but it's kind of okay because he completely let himself go anyway.
And I want to thank also the men and women from the wonderful company that I helped grow, World Wrestling Entertainment, because without them, I could not be standing here on this stage tonight. So I want to thank them. And of course, I'd like to thank my husband, Vince, who stood beside me and behind me all the way through this.
Can you hear me?
Hi, what's your name?
It's Deanna.
Deanna.
Oh boy, oh, that's wow. Jim Carrey. He's
this
your stylist
amazing.
Today.
It's completely sexless, Deanna. The Lloyd thing. Okay, yeah. So.
Deanna, are you sure you want to do this?
Yeah, yeah.
All right. Great.
I think I'm, I think
Jim.
At this
He's
point.
He's going to do a good job.
At this point, I think I know what I'm doing.
Let's go back to Jim Carrey out on Hollywood Boulevard to see how that haircut is going. Oh, wow. Wow!
See?
That is unexpected.
Yes. It symbolizes the control I have over the mind of my fans.
Were you expecting a haircut of that severity?
Me?
Yeah, you.
No, I came down just to see the show.
Oh, you did? Okay.
And subtle, but in even many ways more profoundly devastating, is the lasting damage to the survivors' will to rebuild and remain in the area. The destruction of the spirit of the people of southern Louisiana and Mississippi may end up being the most tragic loss of all.
George Bush doesn't care about black people.
Please call.
I will slightly hesitantly go, dear, final answer. So
I'm not even going to look at the screen. That's the correct answer. It isn't. What? It is a deer. Is it not a deer? I've seen them in Africa boinging along like deers.
Oh, no, you've just lost. £15,000.
We gotta get the mic thing.
What was that? Yeah.
I'm just energy-wise.
Energy-wise.
We talked yeah. about this before. He knows I just can't stand him. Are you retiring?
Excuse me?
I love him. Not really, I do. Like, if
you just won in 6 years most awkward start to an interview, I think.
This one you might not want to pet because
oh
they're spiky.
God. Oh my God.
Now.
Comes from down under, but the direction they're heading is straight up. Recently, they made their debut on the Billboard 200 number 2 this summer, and now we welcome one. Guys, I'm the worst reader. they're only getting bigger. Take a look.
What does that say?
Yeah. I don't. Mariel.
Mariel Street.
Mariel Street.
Mariel Street. Hope Springs, and
oh
she's
my gosh.
The
she
sassy
plays
sheriff.
That sassy
sheriff. I'm Hope Springs. And
Southern, that accent.
Well, hi, everybody. It's nice to see you. Y'all look pretty good 17 years later. Thank you to the HFPA for inviting me back to the family reunion, especially with all these extraordinary ladies this year. I mean it, your work moves me. It moves me, and I've been cheering for y'all from theater seats for a long time. Being on a list with you is cool.
2,000 years later.
Who thanks their agents first? Me, Kevin Huvane, Brian Lord, Peter Levine, Nicole Perna, Dom, Appel, Macy, John Carabino. My partners in crime, I just have to thank you for always reminding me that the top doesn't matter.
Kill me. We're nearly done. Jesus. It's already. Right,
hold the left tree. There you go.
Oh! Yeah! Yes!
Got it!
Yes!
We started to. That was awful. We started to. It turned into a high five and it just fell apart. It was. I never want to do that again.
Oh, my ink. I have this mic on, so.
Yeah, that's all right.
Be a gentleman and help me off with my foot.
Hey, Cody, can you believe that marriage didn't work out? Yeah, I can't believe your relationships don't work out.
I wake up a mess, I've been smoking cigarettes, and I bet you couldn't guess, I've been dreaming of you. Admit it, I'm impressed by all of your success, but I wish I saw it less, cause I still want you. You call me when you're drunk, when you're feeling all alone.
And I found out that I was really a Nazi, you know. Because my family was German, Hartmann, which also gave me some pleasure. So I'm kind of a, yeah.
Sir?
I what can I say? I understand Hitler. He's not what you would call a good guy, but I understand much about him, and I sympathize with him a little bit. Yes, not, but come on, I'm not for the Second World War, and I'm not against Jews. Susanne Bier is no, not even Susanne Bier. That was also a joke. I am, of course. Very much fought used.
Identity was really questioned, and I think it explores that in a really smart way.
Well, you know, you, I was going to say.
Yeah.
You're so nice.
Oh, excuse me.
So differential.
I think I just blew a little frog out of there.
Has that happened with your son?
Once, when he was 13, he walked in on me giving my husband a favor. He didn't hear anything. He saw the TV. And then he looked, and what do you think we did? Continued. But I grew up...
I think I met you at Snatch. I don't think you remember that. The premiere of Snatch, the movie years ago, which they remember. It's got all the cool dudes in it. Benicio's in that, right? Benicio, Brad, who else was in it? Oh, I was there. Oh, look at, oh, would I get beat up quick in England? Oh my God. Spady or lady, look at this guy. That was me at the premiere, is that hysterical? I didn't know how I got into that, because I didn't know you, but maybe I was famous back then. But I thought it was a great movie that was super cool back then. I knew it was at the DGA, remember that, Directors Guild? Have you done this interview before?
Keep going.